Music and Silence by Rose Tremain. A lamp is lit. Until this moment, when the flame of the lamp flares blue, then settles to steady yellow inside its ornate globe, the young man had been impressed by the profound darkness into which, upon his late-night arrival at the Palace of Rosenborg, he had suddenly stepped. Now he is relieved to see the walls of a panelled room take shape around him. A voice says, "This is the Winterstür, the winter room." The lamp is lifted up. Held high, it burns more brightly, as though sustained by purer air, and the young man sees a shadow cast onto the wall. It is a long, slanting shadow, and so he knows it is his own. It appears to have a deformity, a hump, occurring along its spine from below the shoulder blades to just above the waist. But this is the shadow's trickery. The young man is Peter Clare, the lutenist. And the curvature on his back is his lute. And now the lamp moves, and he must follow. "It may be," says a tall gentleman who hurries on carrying the light, "that His Majesty King Christian will command you to play for him tonight. He is not well, and his physicians have prescribed music. Therefore, members of the royal orchestra must be ready to perform at all times, day and night. I thought it best to advise you of this straight away." Peter Clare's feelings of dismay increase. He begins to curse himself, to berate his own ambition for bringing him here to Denmark, for taking him so far from the places and people he had loved. Then the end of a corridor is reached, and the gentleman stops before a door. He knocks and waits, putting a finger to his lips and leaning close against the door to listen for the command from within. It comes at last, a voice deep and slow, and Peter Clare finds himself in the next minute standing before King Christian, who is sitting in a chair, in his nightshirt. Before him, on a small table, is a pair of scales, and by these, a clutch of silver coins. The English lutenist bows as the king looks up, and Peter Clare will always remember that as King Christian first glimpses him in this dark middle of a winter's night, there comes into His Majesty's eyes a look of astonishment, and, staring intently at the lute player's face, he whispers a single word. "Brawl." "I beg your pardon, sir," says Peter Clare. "Nothing," says the king. "A ghost. Denmark is full of ghosts. Did no one warn you?"
"No, Your Majesty."
"Never mind. You will see them for yourself. We are one of the oldest nations on earth, but you should know that it is a time of storms here, of confusion, of incomprehension, of bitter boiling muddle."
"Of muddle, sir?"
"Yes. This is why I am weighing silver. I weigh the same pieces over and over again to ensure that there is no error. I am trying, piece by piece and day by day, to reimpose order upon chaos."
Peter Clare does not know how to reply to this, and he is aware that the tall gentleman, without his noticing, has gone from the room, leaving him alone with the king, who now pushes the scales aside and settles himself more comfortably in the chair. King Christian lifts his head and asks,
"How old are you, Mr. Clare? Where do you come from?"
A fire is burning in the room, which is the scrivestuer, the king's study, and the small chamber smells sweetly of applewood and leather. Peter Clare replies that he is 27 and that his parents live in the town of Harwich on the east coast of England. Then His Majesty stands up and moves towards the fire where Peter Clare is standing and takes up a lamp and holds it near the young man's face. He examines the face, and Peter Clare lowers his eyes because he has been warned not to stare at the king. This king is ugly. King Charles I of England, King Louis XIII of France, these are handsome men at this perilous moment in history. But King Christian IV of Denmark, all-powerful, brave and cultured as he is reported to be, has a face like a loaf. The lutenist, to whom, by cruel contrast, nature has given...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.